Put your hands together for Jesus Christ. Walking against you, we begin to celebrate with you.
Amen.
It's a better amen.
Amen.
Every force standing against you, we bow by God's mercy.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want to thank God for our life. I want to thank God. I am standing here by His grace.
Amen.
Come on, celebrate Jesus Christ. This morning, I want to bless you with three types of captivity. Three types of captivity. I want to tell us, I want to speak to us briefly, and I know by God's mercy, by His grace, I'm going to run through this for 30 minutes, and I know by God's grace, shall be a blessing to our life.
Amen.
Open your Bible with me to the book of Job, chapter 1. Job, chapter 1. Captivities. I want to talk about three types of captivity, and it shall be well in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Job chapter 1, I want to read from verse 6. From verse 6 to 22. Job chapter 1. From verse 6. Now there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan came also among them. Please, beloved, I want you to flow with me. And the Lord said unto Satan, whence comest thou? Then Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the heart, and from walking up and down in it. Yes. And the Lord said unto Satan, hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the heart, a perfect and upright man, one that feareth God and escheweth evil. Escheweth evil. Escheweth evil. Hallelujah. The one that shuns evil. Verse 9. Then Satan answered the Lord and said, doth Job fear God for naught? Does you come to church for naught? Does you come to church for naught? Serve God for naught? Or love God for naught? Because of something. When little thing happen, people go back to their shell. Beloved, God, for God to have allowed anything to happen to you, He may allow another thing to happen. That's what I'm saying, captivity.
Captivity.
When one is in captivity, meaning you are enslaved, you are in prison, you are incarceration. One can be enslaved by one thing or the other. It could be anything. Verse 10, has not thou made a neck about him and about his house, about all that he had on every side? Thou hast blessed the work of his hand, and his substance is increased in the land. It was the fellow pastor that afflicted that drew arrow to that pastor. Hello, church. Fellow pastor was the one that actually drew arrow. Fellow pastor, they were the one that killed the man. It wasn't God. Very untimely. They were still planning for his 16th birthday, that the wife has done everything possible. They were planning, put everything in place. And he slept last night. From there, bye-bye to everything. The office now, the moment they get there, don't you know, beloved, you won't die untimely.
Amen.
Say better amen.
Amen.
Say, you won't die untimely.
Amen.
You will not die untimely.
Amen.
You will not die untimely.
Amen.
I believe God may allow them to do that. Maybe he must have seen certain things we don't know. God needs to forgive us at the time when we are talking. Couldn't concentrate. Say, Lord, have mercy on me. But put forth thy hand now and touch all that he had. God was telling Satan, put forth thy hand now and told all that he had, and he will call thee to thy face. No, Satan was telling, and the Lord said unto Satan, behold, all that he had is in thy power. Only upon himself, put not forth thy hand. So Satan went forth from the presence of the Lord. Abraham was with the Lord. Many a time God may allow something to happen to you. You don't need to complain. The Bible recalls all things work together for them that love the Lord, and he has not come to his purpose. Don't be too complaining. You may not find job there. God may be planning better things there. You may be complaining of a husband. God may be planning president for you. You may be complaining of a child. God may be planning triplets.
Amen.
You may be complaining of the council flower where you live that you are tired of. God may be planning a mission for you.
Amen.
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 You need to come to Africa. Come and see us. See you have us here. I will stand in front of some houses. Some houses. I will say, Lord, the God of heaven, who built this one? Build this for the members of our church.
Amen.
Please, amen. Don't say amen by star.
Amen.
When you appreciate good things, you become beautiful house. Sister Jackie, beautiful house. Some of them they don't know God the way you know God, and some do. And there was a day when his sons and his daughter were eating and drinking wine in their heavens. Brothers, watch this. And there came a messenger to Job and said, the oxen were blind and the ashes feeding beside them. Yes. And the serpents fell upon them and took them away. Yeah. They have slain the servant with the head of the sword. And I only escaped alone to tell thee. Watch this. While he was yet speaking, there came also another who said, the fire of God is falling from heaven. The fire of God is falling from heaven to kill those things that belong to Job. And I burned all the sheep and the servant and consumed them, and only I am escaped alone to tell thee. Verse 19. And behold, there came a great wind from the wilderness and smote the four corners of the house, and it fell upon the young men, and they are dead, and I am escaped alone to tell thee again. Then Job arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down upon the ground and worship who? In whatever you are going through, worship the Lord.
Amen.
And said, naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thy. The Lord gave and the Lord had taken away. The Lord gave and the Lord had what? Taken away. Things that belong to God, the way we do it, as if, oh, if God should take it back. Now you start crying. 1998, me and my wife, we lost a child. We just pray within an hour or two. I've been a woman, but me, move on immediately. I've been planning whether trees I'll put there again. No woman will be crying. It doesn't matter. If by God's grace, you are 60, if you want to see one, a child, God can still do it.
Amen.
Don't shake your head, please let me say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If you are 70, if by God's will, if God wants to do something and you refuse to take it, he will just hide it there. By the time you realize it, you'll just be in the toilet. Maybe you are taking your shower. You just see the baby coming out. Stop looking at God as if God has forgotten. As you said, naked came high out of my mother's womb. Yes. And naked shall I return there. The Lord gave and the Lord had taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Nobody wants bad things to happen to them. But when bad things happen, stop looking at for excuses.
Mm-hmm.
Just bless God.
Amen. Amen.
Just bless God. Amen. The wife of my friend that passed away, the wife, when I called the wife, she said to me, well, study, what can we do? He's gone. But God will still remain God. So wow. Only few women can say that. What can we do? He's gone. He's gone. In all this, Job sinned not. Watch this. In all this, Job sinned not, nor cheered, nor charged God foolishly. Why are you charging God foolishly? Don't put yourself in captivity. Three types of captivity. To be a slave. Captivity means, brother, to be a slave, to be in prison, to be incarceration. You can enslave yourself by things that have gotten hold of you. Attitude. Number one type of captivity is God captivity. He allowed Satan to try Job, and Job would try. He took everything away. God's captivity. God himself allowed Job to be tried. When you are going through something in life, never complain. Never complain about your situation. Never complain about what you are going through. Ezekiel chapter 5, 8 and 9. Quickly. God's captivity. People, at times we forget who God is. Whatever you are going through in life, believe, just worship God. Just give glory and honor to God. When God puts you in a position, or put someone in your family in a position, and they are arrogating, they are showing up, you better begin to pray for them. The God that shoots you up can bring you down.
Yes.
Am I talking to somebody?
Yes.
Ezekiel chapter 5, 8 and 9. Therefore, thus said the Lord God, behold, high, even high, I am against thee. Watch this. God, I'm talking about God's captivity. I am against thee, and will execute judgment in the midst of thee, in the sight of the nation. That's God's judgment. God's captivity. When God wants to put people in captivity, they do not know that they are in captivity. But they still will think that they are still enjoying the good things of life, not knowing that they are in captivity. Bondage. Say to yourself, I am coming out.
I am coming out.
Say it again, I am coming out.
I am coming out.
Say, I am coming out.
I am coming out.
Verse 9. And I will do indeed that which I have not done. That will not be our portion.
Amen.
Many times when God has put you in a problem, he knows how to get you out.
Amen.
When he puts you there, he will take you out.
Yes.
No human being can take you out.
Amen.
God puts you there, he will bring you out.
Amen.
And when you are seeking man to bring you out, they will give you more.
Yes.
They will give you more in the problem. You are going through the problem and you want people to bring you out, they may not be able to. Some may even be willing to bring you out because they haven't got the strength. Number two, captivity. Human's captivity. You know the story of Pharaoh and Israel, how he put them in a serious bondage. They groan, they complain. Look at the book of Exodus chapter 2. 23 to 25, quickly. Beloved, God is doing something. Now, he's raising his own army.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Yes, people that will glorify him. People that will worship him. People that will exalt his name. People that will serve him in spirit and in truth. Make no mistake, people now are yearning for more of God. I was in a town called Shagamu in Nigeria, in Ogun State. Beloved, you won't believe it. In that place, it's another big city. People were crying for God. A big church. They were yearning for more of God. In fact, you will think, Lord, what is happening here? You will even think you are in abroad. You don't look down on people that live in Africa or in the Caribbean anymore. Look at somebody and say, you better wake up now.
Wake up.
Don't think because you are in England and they are in Caribbean, you are better than them. You are making an error. Don't think because you are here and they are in Africa, you want to say to yourself, you are better than them. No! You need to know what is happening. People are serving God more. The more they serve God, the more God is blessing them. The more they are coming closer, the more God is doing something great. I hear on Friday, Pastor Willa said something. Said, dwelling too much on your present situation may prolong your wilderness. And she said something again. But if you always focus on your Creator, He will always come up with an answer.
Yes.
For that particular problem, I wrote some things down. I said, Lord, this is wonderful.
Amen.
When you are dwelling too much on your problem, dwell too much on the captivity. Dwell on God.
Yes.
Dwell on Him. When God sends you an assignment to go and do something, the first thing you face is problem there.
Yes.
Am I saying something?
Yes.
I know you are used to pass off for the last 4 or 5 weeks, but you better get used to me now. You see, continue to see me. Because I am here for good.
Oh yes. Oh yes.
Until September, I'm going to Canada. Amen.
Amen.
I am here for good.
Amen.
You are used to posh way she talks, and posh way she explains things, and a very posh and good looking way she does things. But look at me. I am on fire for God. I just came back from Nigeria. Something breaks about up in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, Exodus chapter 2. 23 to 25. Watch this. And it came to pass in the course of time that the king of Egypt died. Those who are standing tall in your life as Goliath, God will take them away.
Amen.
And the children of Israel sighed by reason of the bondage. And they cried. Bondage is another good word for captivity.
Yes.
Bondage. Bondages.
Yes.
Another good word for captivity. And they cried. And their cry came up unto God by reason of the bondage. So how do you cry to God? How do you speak to God? How do you bring yourself before them and say, Lord, these are the things I've been going through. Lord, have mercy on me. He's a good God. He's a very good God. Amen.
Amen.
And God had their groaning. And God remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. Because of where you came from. Because of some of us, we came from satanic environment. Those who gave birth to us were Hebrew. God should not remember the covenant concerning that. He has to remember the real covenant of Abraham concerning you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Some of us, where we came from was terrible. They were very fetish. Very occultic, very satanic, very demonic, very satanic, very evil, evil-minded. But because of God's mercy and his grace, everything he has promised you this year, there shall be manifestation.
Amen.
And God had a groaning. And God remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. Watch this. And God looked up upon the children of Israel, and God had respect unto them. Ah, God will have mercy on you.
Amen.
Maybe you're in captivity. Don't know what is happening. You're thinking, Lord, what is going on? Acts chapter 4, quickly. I've never been troubled in my life. Last week, I came, stroke this. I said, Lord, what is going on? I said, my son, all things work together, you should know. Those I have taken, they are making heaven. Yes, they are making heaven. Amen?
Amen?
You don't need to cry. You need to worship me so that you can make heaven when the time comes.
Amen.
Acts chapter 4 from verse 1. Acts of a person. Human captivity. When you are in human's captivity, they may not release you on time. When you are being enslaved by a fellow human being, they may use you until they dump you. Excuse you and dump you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
But watch this. When you are under their captivity, God may release you from their hand. When you're groaning, actually, alright. When you actually grown in a proper way and say, Lord, have mercy on me. I'm going through this problem. I've told you before, those who are waiting for at you, you don't need to return what they are doing. Just celebrate God. When a man's ways are pleasing with God, we make all his enemies to what? To be at peace. Those who are troubling you, God knows how to trouble them. When God wants to promote the president of Nigeria, do you know what he did? The one that was a weapon, he put sickness in his body. People are complaining, we don't want Hausa, we don't want Hausa, we don't want Hausa. A good man, the man was a good man. He put sickness in his body, the man passed away because he has assigned Jonathan Obele-Gulo to be the president. Who can stop God's purpose? Nobody. It may look as if things are not working. It may look as if things are not right. It may look as if you are compromising. It may look as if what is happening around you. But very and very soon, you will have every call to rejoice.
Amen.
Always ask for a precise answer to whatever you may be going through, precise answer. Acts chapter 4 from verse 1. And as they spake unto the people, the priests and the captain of the people on the temple, and the Sadducees came upon them, being grieved that they taught the people and preached through Jesus the resurrection from the dead. Watch this. And they lay hands on them and put them in hold unto the next day, for it was now even time. They lay hands on them, put them in prison. Many of us who are sitting in bondages of human beings, you shall be released today. Yeah. Bondages, satanic bondages, evil bondages. You know, I went through those acute headaches. I couldn't sleep. I've never done it in my life, not been able to sleep for two days. I'm becoming so lame. My eyes were red, reddishing away. I have to call for my driver to come and pick me. We went straight to a mountain. I was scared about her. We traveled about an hour and a half. I was just praying. The moment we got there, I knelt down. Those who have been praying with me, I have about seven prophets praying with me. Just praying for you. Pray for you. Pray for the church. Pray for the member. They can't be praying for the world. Just for you. You are looking unto God for prayer. You are getting it.
Amen.
You are looking unto God for a man, you are getting it.
Amen.
A wife, you are getting it.
Amen.
Everything, you are getting it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And their words were never. It was the same thing they were saying were the same. The moment they lay eyes on me, they said, you are a chosen person. I said, I know. Speak another one. I know that. They have told me in London that the God has called me. Everybody know they have seen their, they have seen dream, they have seen revelation, isn't it? So why? They said, you know, I thought you will hear something that will make you shame. They said, 2 days ago would have been the barrier. I said, what happened? I opened my eyes. Wow. You went through a day, precisely, headache for 48 hours. I said, I look at my brother. Even my brother was almost behaving like an unbeliever at times. Doesn't like to hear revelation. He said, this is real. Said, no. Meaning, brother, this is real. Said, brother, this one is real. I said, don't tell me, I can hear it myself. Put my finger in my pocket to take about 3,000 hours. I didn't know, realize when I took the whole bunch out. I said, that was it, Mr. Sorry, it wasn't a mistake. I need to play. Shout hallelujah. Say to yourself, I'm still alive. Say, I am still alive. Say, I am still alive. They told me, but you're not going to die. You need to know who they are. They tried you, but I came into your head. There was a hand that came from heaven. Why they threw the arrow? That hand just came. I said, Lord, I thank you for the arrow. When one is attacked, beloved, you can pray to be a pastor. It's not his job. I said to myself, I won't go there. You know, remaining 2 days to go. I said, no, I'm not going to go there. When I go home, I said, no, I have to go. When I got there, I said, you need to hear. You sit down here. My brother said to me, this man. Shall be
hallelujah.
So when I was inside playing, now when you are in that class, you know that class. You know the contrary they gave me. In fact, I was sitting like a monkey. I didn't want to sleep. My sleep almost came. I said, no, you sleep. I have to pray till I get to London. I said, you discipline, won't crash. I was going to and fro. I passed that class, the last one. When I went there, they saw me. I said, don't look at me as if I'm posh. I am just praying in tongues everywhere. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Say, my time has come.
My time has come.
Captivity. How big men of them which had the world believe, and the number of them, the men, was about 5,000. God in his mercy will increase you this year.
Yeah.
Through what you are hearing, God will increase you.
Yeah.
I said, God will increase you.
Yeah.
God will increase you.
Yeah.
Jehovah will increase you.
Yeah. Yeah.
From this moment, you need to begin to see yourself as a millionaire.
Yeah.
Start to walk right, walk posh, talk posh, yeah. Hit posh. All those street words you are eating, change time, $2.99. Change food, change your diet, change everything.
Yeah.
If you can't afford to buy waterbed, begin to live like a millionaire, go and press waterbed.
Yes.
Pour the gallon of water on your bed and say you are waterbed. Say, you water bed, I can afford you now. But gallon of water, you are free in my house.
Yeah.
And you get to your bed, you spray the water there, and you lie and say, you are water bed from today.
Yeah.
Don't cover yourself.
Yeah.
Stand up and let's glorify.
Yeah.
Number three is self-captivity. Self-captivity. I'm going to explain them because of time. Next week, I may explain them. Human captivity number two, self-captivity number three. When you look at the book of Kings, chapter 19, 14 to 18, when Elijah worked for God, it came to a point, he began to complain. He put himself in a captivity himself. And God said, because of the zeal, you are complaining of what you have been doing. Don't you know who I am? There are thousands here who have not even bowed their head to Baal.
Yes, yes.
Self-captivity. Don't complain about your zealousness. Don't complain about what you are giving. Don't complain about your commitment. Don't complain. I am the only person. I come to church regularly. I am the only person. If not because of me. If not. Don't complain. Don't put yourself in a self-bondage. I've told you, this church is not a church, Nigerian church. It's a church for all nations.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Church for all nations. I want us to pray this prayer. If I come up from the podium here. Say, every captivity of my life, release me today. Speak to God Almighty. Yes! Jesus, another day we are praying. Let's pray this prayer again, beloved. Forces dominating the affairs of my family. Today, I cancel you totally. I bury you in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray to God. Kamo shatala nasimu. Mese kamo shakene nosumuya. In Jesus' name we are praying. During the choir ministration, you know, I was just quietly there, just listening, and I saw this wall was painted black. During that ministration, from that black wall, a kind of a formation of door just opened. When it opened, I was waiting for that door to close, but it remained open like that. From that blackness, that place is open, door to door. And I began to inquire the Lord, why this darkness, why blackness, why this door? Say, my son, this is the door that closed on somebody here. I've opened it today. From today, you will jubilate. You will celebrate. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. today.
Amen.